What's up, classy asses? This is podcast class path number
class path.
78.
It's class pad.
Please keep that in.
You know, that's staying. I'm not editing.
What's up, assy classes? This is class act podbean.
Classy asses.
78. What number are we on?
13.
Oh, Rob. 13.
Oh, 13.
13.
Oh, shit. I'm not superstitious, but 13, man. Yeah.
Well, yeah. You know, I did fuck up the intro already.
That's
okay. You know who we are.
We know, yeah. So there's Jeff, and there's me, and there's Rob. You've probably got it figured out by now.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and get it started. I had a question for you guys, actually.
Already with the questions?
That I was curious about. Now, I mean, this is just something I was, in general, curious about. What is your favorite and least favorite comic book movie?
Ooh.
Which one?
I'm trying to think. That's a good one.
I mean, like, what is the worst fucking to me,
freaking X-Men 3.
X-Men 3? Really? That's the worst one you've ever seen.
Really? Well, Judge Dredd?
Maybe because I was I'm a big X-Men fan, so.
Yeah,
right.
Enough. Yeah.
I don't know. I didn't hate X-Men 3 that much. I know a lot of people did, but they did some things that I really liked. Like, it's the first one where you get to see full-on Iceman. They killed Cyclops. He was a bitch.
He was written like a bitch.
You know, he got, you know, Colossus and Beast and all that. They had some good moments. But, yeah, I mean, it wasn't a great movie. I'm excited about the new one, but, it wasn't great.
All right, question.
Yeah.
Regarding that.
Uh-huh.
Can I say, like, Turtles 3?
Yeah.
Because that's a piece of shit.
It is really bad.
And that's, like, that one, I mean, Turtles is a comic book.
Right.
But that movie was really bad.
It was really shithouse.
Mm.
I mean, it was really...
Nah, it was shit. There's nothing redeeming.
Really bad.
There's nothing redeeming.
No.
Even as a kid, I was like, that was a piece of shit.
Right. I remember there was an Asian girl I thought was dope in it, but
I don't remember because that film is shit.
I just remember the little boy's name was like Yoshi, and he had an older sister, and his older sister.
I'll need to watch it again to see.
At least from what I remember. Anyway, yeah, my pick for worst is probably Steel.
The show. I forgot
about freaking Steel.
That movie is
it's pretty
fucking
horrible.
Bad. That movie is so bad.
So you watched it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
We also watched Kazam.
Okay, have you seen Kazam? I was like, have you paid for that in the cinema?
I have seen Kazam.
No, have you? I know you've seen Kazam.
Yeah,
you seen Kazam? You loved it?
As a kid, I was like, this is awesome. I want a genie.
I'm just imagining little Jeff being like, oh, nigga, I want Shaq to be my best friend.
Actually, it's not even about Shaq. I'm just thinking a genie in general. Like, that's why Aladdin was there.
You were in love with Shaq. Don't pretend. He had fucking Shaq Fu and shit. Oh, God.
Okay,
no,
well,
Steel, though.
Steel is worse than Kazam.
Steel is terrible bad.
Yeah.
It is awful.
So I should take that off your Christmas gift list.
Please. Please do.
I'll get special edition.
Oh, God. If that exists, I would be surprised. I'm pretty sure no one wants to ever see that movie again. If it even exists on DVD, I'd be surprised.
I'm pretty sure Shaq does.
You think he would want it? I don't think he would want it. I'm sure he's ashamed
of
that shit.
Man. No way. He's like, I'm an actor.
Yeah, Old Spice guy. Old Spice commercial dude.
I don't remember it. Yeah, Rob, movie, worst comic. Did you say one already?
Wait, my favorite X-Men. One? I didn't say my
worst
favorite
one.
It's
X-Men, right?
What was your worst one?
No, the worst one was X-Men.
Oh, it was okay. X-Men 3, was that's X-Men, right. Okay.
Yeah.
But your favorite one, what was your favorite one?
I know I might be biased, but I would have to say the Avengers.
Easily. I mean, I don't know why. I don't know if that counts as biased.
Why are you fighting it?
Yeah, I feel like that's the correct answer.
It's the absolute best superhero movie. Right under that, I would say Man of Steel, just because I enjoyed that shit. Yeah, it pictured Superman in how I always seen Superman. Yeah. To me.
Well, I really liked Man of Steel. but I would not say that he depicted Superman exactly how I would imagine.
But it was
not
good.
Him as
it
an actor.
Like, it wasn't a terrible depiction.
Not him as an actor.
It had nothing to do with the acting. Mm. It was really like, is Superman the Dragon Ball Z fighter that snaps niggas' necks and busts through buildings and shit?
That's
I don't imagine that.
I just want to watch it.
Do you remember? The WB Superman cartoon was kind of like that.
They did have scenes where they fucked up building and shit, but even on those old Superman cartoons, from what I remember, Superman always, his priority was protecting the people that were in the middle of that shit.
That's true.
Yeah.
And in that movie, he didn't seem all too worried unless you were Lois Lane.
that's fair. I mean,
yeah, it's true.
You can question, we can question.
Man,
that
but
all
I'm
you
saying
want.
I liked it anyway. I'm not saying the movie was bad.
I know
I'm
what I
saying,
did like about it was the fact that I guess they got right off the bat that Lois knew who Superman was, because I always thought the lamest thing was her not knowing who Clark Kent is and Superman is at the same time.
Well,
just because of glasses.
We don't know for that for sure.
It's implied, though.
It is implied, but it is never. She never like winks at him or nothing to make sure that she knows. She just smiles at him and is nice and says, "Welcome to the planet." And everyone's like, she's got to fucking know. She's Lois, right? She saw him an hour ago. But so did Perry White and all those other motherfuckers, and they didn't know who he was.
Hmm.
I guess we'll have to wait.
Yeah.
But, yeah, best, like, there's a handful of really good ones.
Yeah. Small handful.
Avengers, but I love Dread.
Yeah, the new Dread was awesome.
It's in top five, man.
My number two, Ninja Turtles 1.
But that's awesome.
Yeah.
Well, right, that's why I pick it. Ninja Turtles 1 is my second favorite one. And then it'd be a bunch of other ones that probably no one would ever put on their top list.
Like
The Crow, I think is great. Comic book movie. The Watchmen, and
Watchmen was pretty good.
I enjoyed The Watchmen, man.
And Sin City, fantastic.
Yeah, Sin City was good. Sin City was probably the most truest adaptation.
Oh yeah,
yeah, without a doubt.
But like rounding out my top five ish, probably Scott Pilgrim.
Yeah, that was good.
Loved that movie.
See, that's what I'm saying. Like, there's actually a lot of really good ones.
Yeah.
But on the flip side, favorite and least favorite video game based movie.
This is tough because a lot of shit.
All right. Well, for me, Resident Evil.
I want to hear Rob's opinion.
Resident Evil. I hate the series. Seriously.
The series, the entire thing. You would not watch.
I only watched the first one, and yeah.
See, you should give it another
chance.
That's
the
problem,
the other,
though.
Man.
But that's the problem, though. It's kind of far off. It's so far off from the canon that I just can't.
Sort of, but they try to bring it back around towards that.
It's too late.
In the last couple.
It's too late for that.
They tried.
I didn't have fun with them. I didn't see the very last one.
I've seen them all.
But I saw the one before that where they brought in like Wesker and Jill and all that shit.
I have seen them all.
But that's probably, you know what? That's probably my bias. I'm pretty sure they're pretty good movies in their own right without me, you know, hating on them because I'm a purist.
Right.
But yeah. I think probably the worst series of movies.
House of the Dead.
House of the Dead was pretty fucking awful. But really, let's be honest. The House of the Dead game isn't all that great.
It wasn't, but they made the game so atrocious. I mean, the movies.
I played the Typing of the Dead more than the House of the Dead.
For me, it's definitely, as far as video game movies are concerned, it's got to be either
Mario Brothers,
original Street Fighter or Street Fighter Legend of Chun-Li.
I turned Legend of Chun-Li off halfway.
I watched Street Fighter.
I don't know. I think Mario Brothers is the worst.
Nah, fuck you.
At least like when I was a kid, I enjoyed Mario Brothers. Yeah. I mean, it had nothing to do with the real fucking Mario, but it was at least enjoyable. I remember walking out of Street Fighter and being like, "Nigga, what the fuck was that?" I probably didn't say it exactly like that.
That would be great.
But I remember talking to my dad and being like, because my dad took me to see it, and I remember distinctly walking out of the theater and being like, that was nothing like the game. Like, I just remember being like, Dad, no one threw a fireball. Not a single person.
Hey, they had rocket boots, though.
No, I'm talking about in Street
Fighter. Oh, wait, Freaking Street Fighter.
Not a single person threw a fireball.
That's true.
The closest thing was you had Ryu flick Vega in the nipples, and there was a flash of light. But that was literally...
See, when you said that, I was like, I'm pretty sure he didn't flick him in the nipples. That would have been weird.
Nah.
He just fucking
go back and
him.
Look, man.
No, I'm pretty sure. Like, not literal flicking the nipple.
That's what it looked like to me. And then you see Vega's booty bounce. He's twerking on when he hits the floor.
That really sucked
it. It really did. It really did.
Mortal Kombat was a good one.
Mortal Kombat was good, yeah.
Mortal Kombat 1 was fun.
That's probably my favorite video game movie.
Live action, yeah. I mean, I've seen the Tekken one.
Right.
That one's not bad. The fighting is good.
The problem with the Tekken movie for me is that it's an okay movie, but it's about on par with Mortal Kombat.
Yeah.
Which is not a good thing because it was made over a decade after Mortal Kombat.
Well,
it feels
be
like it was made at the same time.
Yeah.
But Mortal Kombat is probably my favorite one. I haven't seen a lot of them, though. Like, I haven't seen, like, Doom or any of that shit.
I like Doom. I enjoyed it. I thought it was fun.
Yeah, Doom was pretty good.
Yeah, it was fun.
Where would you rank in, like, Advent Children?
Advent Children?
It's still a movie.
So we can do animated?
Sure.
Then Street Fighter 2, the animated movie.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorites. The animated movie is good. It's one of my favorite, and it's probably my favorite anime movie.
That one's excellent.
But I don't know. I think as far as video game specific movies are concerned, I'd probably still rank Mortal Kombat as the top.
Advent Children was cool.
Yeah. Advent Children was a fun one.
The Blu-ray version of Advent Children is the best one, I think.
Had extra shit.
Yeah, it just flowed better. What's it felt like a movie. Huh?
What is your favorite one though?
My favorite animated movie.
Yeah.
Video game movie. That is actually a good question.
Because you're a purist with most of these things, so you'd like it to be as close as possible.
Yeah.
Or what about even series based on video games?
What you mean? Oh, you mean like TV series and whatnot? Yeah.
Have there been many?
Well, there have been like, you know, the Mario Brothers Super Show, the Zelda show. They had a Mortal Kombat animated series, Street
Sonic.
Fighter. Sonic.
Saturday AM, Sonic is probably the best cartoon series, I think, for a video game. The Archie.
Right.
That was fun.
I'm trying to think of movies, though.
Did you guys watch the Power Stone series?
Yeah, it's not as good.
I only watched, like, three episodes that were randomly placed in the middle of the series.
Mm-hmm.
And I had no idea what was going on.
Yeah, it's pretty random.
I like, feel like it should be so easy.
Yeah, whoever written it did not know the source of the game. That's how I see it.
I don't think a lot of them did.
Yeah.
What about like the Fatal Fury movies?
Oh, I fucking love them.
Yeah, all the Fatal Furies are dope.
How would you rank those next to Street Fighter?
On par for me.
Yeah, it's pretty similar. But I don't know, man. Street Fighter 2 animated movie was pretty
amazing.
Yeah.
I definitely enjoyed it.
The Fatal Fury ones, man. I think it's because I grew up with them.
Yeah, it all depends what you grew up with. I know the Street Fighter 2 anime movie was around when I was like really getting into anime, so it had a lot of impact on me as a kid.
Right.
And actually, I saw the Fatal Fury movies late, like 2000.
I saw them early, man.
Yeah,
I saw those a long, long time ago. Mm. They were probably one of the first maybe five animes I ever saw.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd seen, I think in the, like, I can kind of remember. I remember I saw a movie called Go Kaiser.
Mm-hmm. Go Kaiser.
Was probably one of the first ones I saw, which is probably why I'm not huge into anime now, because that movie disturbed me greatly.
The themes are a bit fucked up.
I just remember I was like, the villains are like incestuous and like everybody's boobs bounce all the time for no reason. Going from like the X-Men animated series to this is what next level animation is supposed to be, it wasn't like a great impression.
See, that's the thing. Like, if you grew up with, like, Samurai Pizza Cats, Tekken Man.
I didn't have any of that.
Sailor Moon. You probably would have been a little bit more.
Yeah, easy. Dragon Ball.
I didn't see Dragon Ball Z or Sailor Moon until maybe, like.
Toonami age?
Yeah, until Toonami.
See, then, yeah.
Yeah, I caught those.
If, like, Galkaiser was your first one? That's fucked up.
I had a couple friends that used to watch Dragon Ball, but I didn't know what it was. It just looked really dumb to me, so I didn't check it out.
Okay.
But I think Ghost in the Shell was probably like the second one I saw, and I loved that. And I still see Akira. I didn't see Akira until probably my 20s.
Okay.
Wow. That might be good, though, because your mom might be ready for it.
Yeah, when I first saw Akira, I had no clue what was going on. And then I saw, like, nudity, and I was like, whoa, what is going on?
That was the other one. This movie called Monster Hunter.
Yeah, that was also... and Monster City, Royce.
No, Monster Hunter.
Monster Hunter?
Monster Hunter?
Yes. And
like,
that
like
movie...
Like the video game? The same name as a video game?
No.
Because I remember Monster City.
No, this one had, like, nudity in it at the very beginning. Monster City.
If anybody would know, Jeff would know, because...
Yeah. They're the ones that I remember, like, seeing on VHS and going, why is cartoon breasts? But it was cool, because I'm like, this is not what I'm supposed to watch, but it was in the cartoon section.
Yeah, I think Heavy Metal was that for me.
Heavy Metal was cool.
Yeah.
That was like an anthology, that's why.
Yeah.
You said it's called Monster City?
I think it should be called Monster City.
Ninja Scroll was another anime that kind of fell in that category for me, too.
Is Demon City Shinjuku?
Like that was probably, like, the third one I saw was Ninja Scroll. And that was another one with titties in it. And I was like, I guess just anime means titties. Animated titties.
It might have been Demon City, Russ.
You have to think about it, though. Anime back then was purely, like, I guess considered the R-rated movie. Like, animated R-rated movie. And a lot of R-rated movies had that in it.
Right.
So I think that's the distinction of what made anime, because it was tailored towards, like, adults, but and not for kids. So when kids saw it, it's like, whoa, what is going on in here? Technically, they were watching animated R-rated movies.
How old is the Monster Hunter game series?
That started, like, in 2003. I was working at a game store when that happened. 2004, 2005, something like that.
I think first game was 2004.
Yeah, 2004.
PlayStation 2.
Yep.
So that's not tied to the anime that you watched.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Maybe it was just before.
I typed in Monster Hunter and nothing pops up.
It's not Monster Hunter. I figured it out in the most unfortunate way possible.
What is it?
It was called Biohunter.
Oh, Biohunter!
And it's by the director of Ninja Scroll.
Yep. I've seen that one.
And the very opening scene in that movie...
It's fucked up, right?
He gets his, like, hands eaten off by a chick's titties or something.
Mm-hmm. It's fucked up.
And I was just like, this is the worst possible thing I could have seen at 11 years old.
Yeah. Animation was good, though, man.
Yeah. If you compare the animation to the animated X-Men, it just doesn't...
It's weird, because it's like, these were produced roughly the same time.
Yeah. Like, I watched animated X-Men, 90s X-Men, like, about a couple months back, just one episode, and it just wasn't happening.
Right.
Yeah.
If anyone was curious, though, how I found it, what I typed into Google was, titties eat a hand anime. And the first thing that pops up is Biohunter.
Cool. They know how to label that, right? It was labeled. It's like one day Royce is going to look for this.
No, what it means is I'm not the only one where that's what stuck with them.
Of course not.
Is a titty eating a hand.
You got to happen sometimes. Sometimes.
That was amazing. That is awful. Yeah, I am traumatized by even the slight memory of this movie. And I don't really remember too much else from it, honestly.
Other than that.
I remember the, like, main monster face, and I remember that opening scene, because it's, like...
Embedded?
Yeah, it's, like, really graphic, hardcore sex, and then one of her tits has a face on it with like claw teeth. But it's not like regular like sharp fangs teeth. It's like claw teeth because her lip looks like a bunch of fingers with claws hanging out of it.
I think we need to rent this.
No, no. We do not need to.
Are you sure?
This picture of claw titty hand face.
Yeah, I remember. I've seen it.
Yeah, awful. Why is that a thing that exists?
It's a horror anime, though. It's supposed to be fucked up.
Success.
Yeah, success, they've succeeded.
Success.
They achieved exactly what they were after.
And then fucking Ninja Scroll too. It was like they had that weird sex scene.
Like yeah, the guy how he just put the whole breast in his mouth.
Yeah, the big.
Because as a kid, I was like, he was a rock.
When I was a kid, I was like, that motherfucker's head had to be huge.
Yeah. Oh, he got it in there.
Yeah, that is something that definitely burned its way into my psyche forever.
And that's how you introduce into anime.
Yep.
Not the best way.
Yep. I mean, but there was some stuff, obviously, that I just didn't know about being anime, like Transformers.
Yeah.
And I had seen the Guyver movies at a really young age.
The Guyvers, man. I was fucking sick.
That was based on an anime. I just thought it was a weird movie that I loved. Loved the Guyver movies.
You know how you say comic book movie adaptations?
Yeah.
We can include manga.
Technically.
Technically.
If you say Dragon Ball Evolution,
no. No, no, no.
Hey, that movie was my jam, though.
I had fun with that.
I loved how Piccolo's antennas were, like, glued to the top of his head. And then Goku turns into some kind of weird monster that chases everybody around at the end of it.
Yeah.
That I guess was supposed to be a monkey.
He was Azara then.
I want to do Dragon Ball Evolution fan art.
Oh, let's do it.
Let's do that shit.
Yeah.
I wonder if anyone's ever done that. Probably not.
Everybody, I don't think anyone would dare. Ooh.
What if we drew the Dragon Ball Evolution characters in Toriyama style?
That's what I was going to say, actually. Like, because their outfits were, like, specific. I think we need to get this done. This
sounds great. Re-looking at Piccolo is so weird.
This sounds great. Like Piccolo? Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I'm actually excited for that now.
Question, Royce. I know this probably not a question that Jeff would answer, but what was the first video game that you stopped playing because of something that spooked you in the game?
Friday the 13th on NES.
That's early.
That's super early.
Yeah.
Dude, that game's music and everything, the whole ambiance of that game, fucking terrifying. And once you get to Jason, you can't do anything about it. He's just fucking, he's like chilling. Oh, you can't see what I'm doing right now, but Jason does this weird like shimmy dance move thing when he's coming at you. And you only have like a split second to run out of the house. Ugh, I hated that. Oh, I hated that game. It scared the fuck out of me. That was definitely the earliest one because that was NES days.
Yeah.
I can't even think of another game that scared me that bad, honestly. I know there was these games that I refused to play. I saw somebody play a little bit of it, and I would never play it. It was like Clock Tower or Watch
Tower. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's Clock Tower.
Yeah, those games, like, I don't even really remember anything except for there was, like, a little dude with, like, giant scissors or some shit like that. And I was like, that game's fucked up.
I never played Clock Tower, Fatal Frame. I played the first Frame. Silent Hill, and that's
never
it.
Never played any Silent Hill games. I'm not into like horror stuff.
Yeah, me
in
neither.
General. So horror games were almost out of the question. I don't even like horror movies. It's just not gonna happen.
I hate supernatural horror. I like Resident Evil because that's more like mutant biological type of thing. And I could put my hands on
ghosts and shit.
I didn't even. Yeah, skip that. I didn't even like Resident Evil. You saw me play that shit. Once motherfuckers is chasing you, it, like, I don't know. See, this is the difference. If Resident Evil's actual gameplay mechanics were different, I would have played that game the whole way through with you. But the fact that you have to, like, stop to shoot at anything and shit like that, I was like, nope.
Yeah.
If I can't, like, strafe and run backwards and shoot at shit, how the fuck am I going to do it? I'm not going to, like, run 20 feet and then turn around to shoot at a nigga with a giant weapon that is totally seemingly unstoppable.
That's totally understandable because, I mean, that's all – it's genius game design, though, and that's why
– Is it
genius? It is, man, because think about it. It's a horror game, so, I mean, it should take advantage of all kind of ways to scare you. That's how I see it.
If it was me and I had a gun, guaranteed I'm running and shooting at the same time. And I feel like a special agent nigga should be able to do the exact same, if not better, than I could do in a combat situation.
Very true.
Be able to run backwards.
But that's why Resident Evil 6 failed. Because they introduced those mechanics. I didn't even play 6. Right, but that's everybody hate it. Mostly everybody hates it because it's too overpowering. Because you could freaking punch zombies to death. You could hit in every angle. There's no fear factor to it.
I guess. I mean, but that's why I fucking loved Last of Us.
Yeah.
And I don't like zombie games. I don't like scary games or whatever. But I loved the Last of Us.
Last of Us is serious. It's amazing. Yeah.
Like, if that's what the Resident Evil games are like, I would have played all of them.
Yeah.
Designs, man.
Yeah.
Like, just the gameplay was fantastic.
Yeah.
You know, all the, like, if you had to craft something, you had to do it all in real time. If you had to heal, you had to do it in real time.
Yeah.
All that stuff, like, added strategy, added gravitas to the situations. I really love that game.
Very true. I'll tell you the few games that I stopped playing. You guys might laugh at this. Tomb Raider. The first Tomb Raider.
DuckTales scared the shit out of me.
Wait, what game?
DuckTales. That Himalaya stage, dude.
Battletoads scared me because I couldn't fucking figure that shit out.
Freaking jet bike level scared me. Battletoads
Double Dragon, hardest game ever created.
Yeah. Freaking Battle Maniacs, dude.
Yeah, I remember that shit.
Anyway, you were saying Tomb Raider?
Yeah, I used to remember being scared on the early Tomb Raider games. I'll just stop playing. Because, like, tires and stuff be popping out at you and stuff, man. And, like, I guess the pacing of the game really, like, is unsettling in, like, dark areas.
Right.
And it's a different thing about those games. Like, they weren't really, like, fleshed out. Like, the graphics are horrible. So right. They felt kind of alien.
But I'm wondering now, with what graphics are now, if you went back and played that game, if it would still scare the shit out of you.
Probably not.
You don't think it would even faze you? Because you'd be like, everything is a giant square. It doesn't do anything.
I don't know. It depends. It depends on how much I remember the game. Because if I remember the game well, it don't scare me. Jump scares? Yeah. Like, you'll pull a switch or something, and then a bear will come out of nowhere behind you and stuff.
A big, giant Lego bear?
Yeah.
Oh, those graphics were terrible.
This block is chasing me.
It just looked like a big, like, blocky potato brick.
Yeah. It's weird, though, because you know it's a block, but
it's the immersion. Yeah.
Hey, but back then, people were like, oh, these games, so realistic.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Dude, do you remember Mortal Kombat when it first came out?
Yeah, Mortal Kombat. My mom freaked out when she saw it.
They're real people.
Another game that scared me was Super Mario World. And let me explain why. The first castle, I used to always like give the controller to my dad.
Are you hearing
that? What?
Way cool.
Like, what's going on?
It was something that clear audio on our side.
Okay. I think it's back normal now.
It's getting there.
Yeah. That was all right, weird, we're back. I'm going to leave it.
Well, I don't know if it... Because Rob is recording. Well, I don't know if it sounded that on his side.
It probably did.
So it probably sounded... Like, we probably sounded jacked up.
Yeah, it's cool, though.
It sounded tight.
Yeah, I don't know what that was. Anyway, yeah, Super Mario World scared me as a kid.
Like the ghost stages or what?
Not even the ghost stages. The first castle stage. I used to pass controller to my dad. It's because of the music.
I do not even remember it.
They had good music.
Yeah, the music was very unsettling. And I was like, dude, I was like probably 5 years old, 4 years old, something like that. Yeah.
5 years old, huh? That is a lot to take in as a children.
Yeah.
Yeah, no games really scared me.
And I guess that this also brings up the next question. What things scared you that wasn't even supposed to be scary?
I think I asked this to Kanoi not too long ago. I don't remember what her answer was, but I think I asked her about it. What things scared me that aren't supposed to be scary?
Yeah, like you just got really unsettled by it.
I'm trying to think. All the examples that are coming to my head are all things that are probably at least slightly supposed to be scary.
Like what?
Like, freaking, you know, I was...
Like villains in cartoons and stuff.
Oh. I was terrified of Wallace and Gromit and Claymation in general.
Style,
yeah.
He's like, how when they talk, you only see their upper teeth.
Yeah, their teeth is always just smiling.
Yeah, he used to.
That's awesome, dude.
I used to have nightmares about that, dude.
That you had nightmares cool. about Wallace and Gromit.
Yeah, dude.
That is literally the best thing I've ever heard.
Yeah. That's amazing. That is excellent.
Oh shit!
That is excellent.
That is fantastic. I'm not going to have anything that comes close to that.
No, I can't even think.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Nightmares of Wallace
like, and even freaking, Wallace and yeah, Wallace and, like, Claymation in general, I just hated it as a kid.
Hmm.
Like, I didn't even Claymation? Play, I didn't even play Clay Fighter, dude.
What? You yeah. missed out.
What about Stop
I mean, Motion? I played it, but it bothered me.
Clay? Specifically Clay that bothers you?
I
or
think
stop
it's a stop motion?
Motion.
I think it's a stop motion look.
What about in, like RoboCop or something like that.
See, it's different. Like, even dude, even with the freaking, my mind is blank, dude. The freaking robot, what you call that thing, man?
Ed 209.
Yeah, Ed 209. That the way it moved just freaked me out. Like that scene when they were testing it.
Yeah, like stop motion.
Yeah, the scene when they were like they brought it up to test and it just went wrong and shot that dude up.
Right.
It scared the crap out of me as a kid, dude.
That's awesome.
That's kind yeah. of crazy.
Wallace and Gromit. Fucking
Did
love
you have
it.
Anything you were scared of that wasn't supposed to be scary, Jeff?
I think most of the things I was afraid of as a kid kind of were pretty scary. Mm-hmm. Like, the stuff that I remember giving me nightmares was the RoboCop, the guy who got melted in acid.
Yeah.
I think also one of the reasons why that scared the shit out of me is because I was sick. I had, like, a fucking bad flu or some shit, and that's just nightmare territory generally.
Right.
Yeah.
And that kept fucking just, yeah, it kept creeping into my brain, and I did not like that. It's like, oh, help me. I'm like, nope.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm not going to help you. I'm sorry.
Wait, yeah, when you're sick like that, the even good things just have a bad thing attached to
yeah.
it for some reason.
Yeah, exactly. Nah, fuck that. I don't want it.
I got one that I had nightmares of. Now I used to get these two people confused a lot, which didn't help. But back in the day, like early 90s, late 80s probably, I was scared of the guy from C&C Music Factory. And I used to get him confused with Ice-T.
I still do.
Because they were both like light skin.
I still do.
And they both had ponytails.
I'm still pretty sure the same guy.
I had nightmares about that guy.
That doesn't even make any sense.
But listen, they weren't like nightmares that guy was gonna kill me or something. It were always nightmares that guy was going to steal my mom from me. And I was going to just have to learn to raise myself.
Oh, that's your fear.
Yeah.
Was to raise yourself.
Because of that guy, though.
That guy particularly.
Yeah.
I think,
and I just remember that my mom liked that guy a lot. She thought he was great. Thought he was dope. But then I'd be like, oh, no, that guy, he's going to steal my mom. And I would have nightmares about him coming in and be like, this is my mom now. Like, yeah, the C&C Music Factory guy. I've got the power.
Yeah, no, we know. That's awesome.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's probably the weirdest.
Oh, that's excellent.
The weirdest one. I don't even know if I've ever told my mom that one. I'll have to call her up.
Well, you should get her listening to this. Or not.
Oh, yeah, that was probably that's probably the weirdest one I can think of.
I can't think of anything like that's weird. That's like not common to be afraid of.
Oh, you know what?
Slip, slop, slap.
I don't even know what the fuck that was. What was that again? I forget.
What?
Slip, slop, slap.
It's slip on a shirt, slap on a hat, and slop on some sunscreen.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
But do you have a you had a dream you had a dream like that about something like that, like some guy was like Godzilla?
Oh yeah, that's right, that's right. Yep.
Because someone brought that up in like a comment or something.
Yeah, yeah. Because we mentioned that.
I said it last on the last one.
Yeah, yeah.
I hella don't remember that.
Yeah, because Rob quickly mentioned something where it's like, "What do you know of the Australian culture?"
Slip, slap, slap.
Slip, slap, slap, and I started laughing. Because that's a back in the early 90s, there was like a mascot. From what I can remember, my memory is shithouse. So I'm not exactly sure. But I remember it's like a bunyip or some shit.
A what?
A bunyip.
What the fuck is like, a bunyip?
It's like some random make-believe Australian monster.
Great.
Yeah. And he was the mascot. I could be making this up. I'm pretty sure I'm not. Either that was part of my nightmare or not. Anyway, the bunyip was a mascot, and he would teach kids how to be smart during the summer weather. You know, because the sun is pretty fucked up, and you guess, you know, you don't want that stuff. So there was a saying, it was called slip, slop, slap.
Great. That sounds terrible, by the way.
Yeah, it's I remember, which convention was that, Rob, where we were looking at the videos?
Dude, it had to have been...
Baltimore? Yeah,
definitely one that Otacon? I was not at.
Yeah, it was one of those weird ones. But we showed it, and we're just fucking laughing. Because I was like, I told you it's true. I told you. I didn't make that shit up.
That sounds like a pedo mantra.
Maybe slip, slop, slap.
Slip, slop, slap.
It sounds bad. But it, you know, it taught kids how to protect their skin.
How to run and hide mascot.
Yeah, that's right. Cause we didn't believe Jeff, or something like that. Like Jeff was talking about it.
Cause you thought I was making this shit. I'm like, I swear to you, it's real. I swear to you, it's real.
Did it make
this real here? Nah. It's an Aussie thing.
Yeah.
What did the character look like?
He was a bunyip. He looked like...
What the fuck is a bunyip?
I don't... They're not really sure, because there's no real specific description of it.
Wait, but you said... What did it look like? Was it only... Was it never seen?
No, you see it... I guess the mascot looked more like a mutant kangaroo thing.
A mutant kangaroo.
Right? Was that, is that what it was from?
I can't remember, dude.
What was it mutated from?
A kangaroo.
Right, but what parts of it were mutated?
Hold on,
it just looked stupid.
I'm finna look up a bunyip.
Was it just like a different color kangaroo?
I think maybe it was. It just looked weird. It was.
What's it called again?
A bunyip.
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 What in the world?
YIP.
Let me look it up, see if it exists.
Holy crap, this is scary.
Yeah, it's a thing. There you go, it's like a creature.
Alright, everyone, Google bunyip.
Yeah. All right, just type in the bunyip video.
There's a video?
It's called the bunyip video, and it opens up scaring the crap out of me.
Okay, I remember this as a kid. Right? Yeah, it's like a cave painting that comes to life.
What?
This is freaky.
Yeah.
This sounds like a fever dream.
Oh, okay, I guess they changed the mascot.
Of course they did.
Because the slip, slop, slap ad... It later became a bird. A cartoon bird. Possibly a
cocoa bar? What the fuck is that?
This looks weird, dude.
Yeah.
The bunyip looks fucking terrifying.
Yeah. That's what kind of fucked me up. Because I was like, why does it exist?
It doesn't look anything like a kangaroo.
I know. But there's multiple descriptions of it. And
it's like a saber-tooth platypus.
Wow. A lot of people are like on the comments... talking about how much it scared the crap out of them when they were little.
Yeah, see, okay, I guess it wasn't just me then. Bunyip.
That is awful.
But I might have mixed it up with the slip, slop, slap thing, and that scared me more.
I thought the slip, slop, slap dude was like the Michelin man or something.
I guess he was or some shit. I don't remember, but that's a saying from Australia, and the bunyip scared me when I was 5.
Great.
You know, oh, speaking of the Michelin man, the Stay Puft Marshmallow from Ghostbusters scared the crap. Like, the literal crap. Yeah, but that was
supposed to be scary.
Yeah, that's supposed to be scary.
I don't know. No, because I was laughing. Okay, when I first saw Ghostbusters, I was laughing throughout the whole movie. Like, it didn't really scare me.
Until he was a giant
until the freaking, yes, dude. And then he turned all angry. That scared the crap out of me.
It was his expression.
Yeah.
Yeah, because it wasn't friendly. But it looked friendly. But
it looked friendly at first when it was walking around, and it changed its expression. It was super, like, mad.
Angry and shit.
And I had nightmares about that for a while.
That's fine, though, because it's supposed to be a scary movie. It's
scary, though.
Yeah,
I guess.
I mean, it's not Wallace and Gromit.
Yeah, Wallace and Gromit takes the cake.
It's not CNC Music Factory.
Ever, Wallace and Gromit is tighter.
Ah, Rob, that's so good.
Yeah, serious, man.
Two great things.
I told you how, like, way into Michael Jackson I was, right? I was, like, a huge fan. Yeah,
you had the glove and all, right? Yeah.
When the first trials happened, or whatever, the first accusations came out, and they were talking about how Michael Jackson did all that shit to kids, that night I was so traumatized because he was my favorite thing that I had a nightmare about Michael Jackson.
Doing what?
I went to the, not that he was touching me or anything, but that I went to the Neverland Ranch. Neverland Ranch, though? Tim Burton's Batcave.
What?
It was specifically like an underground cave. It looked almost exactly like Tim Burton's Batcave. And I just remember him like, "You're gonna come live with me now."
Your mom's fine. She's with C&C Music Factory.
Right. And then I remember, like, legit, he grabbed me. He grabbed my shirt and lifted me up like he was going to hit me or something. And then his face turned into the robot Michael Jackson face
from Moonwalker.
And he just screamed at me, and I woke up.
Fuck that.
Because you remember how in the Moonwalker, when he turns into the robot, he just goes, and his, like, jaw opens up on the hinge.
That has to be freaking creepy.
Yeah, that scared the fuck out of me as a kid.
Yeah, because like everything exploded.
Yeah,
and his mouth opened really big.
Yeah, that one scared the fuck out of me too.
Okay,
freaking Captain EO scared me.
Especially Captain EO was tight, dude.
But it scared me, and I was when you first seen it in 3D when the freaking lady turns into.
Oh thing. Yeah. The lady that comes out of the ceiling or whatever.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, she was scary. Yeah. I loved Captain EO though.
Captain EO was awesome. But that the little scene,
fucking weird Furby thing I thought was tight.
That one scene just made me launch my 3D glasses off my face. Dude. I was like, no.
We watched that again recently, and I was like, yeah, this is still tight.
Yeah, it's still recently. Oh, yeah, you never... Oh, yeah, dude.
Yeah, I only saw... I didn't see, like, when it first came out.
Well, a lot of those...
to go see that, but...
Oh, yeah.
A lot of those early 3D movies used to freak me out a little bit, though.
I didn't think 3D movies as a kid.
It was only at like places like Disney World and stuff, and Universal.
I think I saw Captain EO in 3D, and I think I saw one of the Nightmare on Elm Street movies in 3D.
Whoa! I would never.
They made that available in 3D.
But it was like old school shitty 3D where it was like the red and blue glasses. I think
that's even freakier.
Yeah.
Wait,
who took you to see that?
My dad did.
Your dad's cool.
And it was the one where it was like the Dream Warriors.
Yeah. Someone had to fight him and shit.
Yeah, where they like fight him and there's like a chick that knows kung fu. Yeah, I thought the movie was awesome.
As a kid, it's cool. I think that was probably the most kid-friendly, which is weird.
Freddy Krueger movies were the only like scary movies I would watch because I thought he was funny.
He was pretty funny.
Except I remember the only scene that sticks out that scared me from Freddy Krueger was to start out with a scene that I just thought was funny was he did this one where he was talking to a girl in middle of class or something and he goes "What a suck face!" And then like his his tongue comes out. And
it's, I remember all that.
Long, and then he just grabs her face and then sucks her face until she turns to like just skin.
There's one scene where the guy gets pulled into the bed.
Right, that's in the first
movie. Yeah, that one fucked me up, kid.
Yeah, that was Johnny Depp.
Yeah, I know. I was like, and every killed time after that, I was like, Jack Sparrow. I don't want to get sucked into the bed.
Did you say the mask used to scare you, Royce?
Yes, the but that was supposed to scare me though.
Which really?
The bad guy from the mask.
Remember, oh yeah. Yeah.
But he was supposed to be scared. Yeah, he was. Like a fucking demon.
His voice.
Damien.
That's my impression.
That was great. I did not know.
It sounded like Scooby Doo a little bit.
It was Scooby Doo with a mask.
Yeah, but he was scary to me.
He was supposed to be scary though. Also, the movie The Gate. Do you remember that movie?
I never watched it.
I remember just him getting the eyeball on his hand and then stabbing it. As a kid, I was like, I don't want eyeballs growing on any part of my body.
I definitely remember
because it was done real well, and that fucked me up as a kid. Yeah. I just kept looking at my palm and I'm going, I don't want an eyeball.
I was really scared of the Blob as a kid.
The Blob scared the fuck. But that's supposed to be
scared the crap out of me.
That scared the fuck out of me.
Yeah,
too.
That's supposed. Yeah.
Yeah, that one's supposed to be scary though. It's not the same.
Yeah.
It's the things that aren't supposed to be scary that you're just like, I don't want that.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a good question though. It stemmed a lot of things.
Yeah, that is pretty funny though.
Any questions from the audience since last?
No. They didn't give a shit.
Not a new one. Huh? I don't think we even really opened it up to questions.
We didn't address the art-related stuff.
Yeah, you'll have to find that.
Should I pull them up?
Yeah, if you want.
All right, I'll go look for them. Yeah, now that we're all here, we can actually answer the art-related stuff.
Artsy fartsy.
See, this is the part that I will cut out.
Yeah.
Everything else I'm keeping. That's good, man. Wallace and Gromit. Love it. CNC Music Factory. I guess we could answer some... Wait, did we answer all of them? Like the work ethic stuff?
We answered a couple of them, but I know a bunch of them. I told you just skip them.
Cause... I don't know which ones we skip.
Right. The ones that were specific to things that they could not answer. Art-related things.
They influence each other. Then we answered, do you ever draw paint abstract art? I think we answered that one. What is your favorite art from each other? I think we answered that one as well. Tips on how someone could break into the comic industry?
I think we answered that one.
Yeah. I think we answered all of them then. Nah, but I know we...
There was definitely a couple of them I told you don't worry about it because they wouldn't be able to answer them anyway.
But I'm looking at the ones here and... I've just read them. You want me to read them all out again?
Sure.
How do you keep so focused and have such strong work ethic?
I think we did that one.
I guess Rob can answer it, though.
How do you keep so focused and have such strong work ethic, Rob?
That's the best.
Great answer. Next question.
I don't know.
Is that the answer?
I don't know. I'm trying to think of an answer. I always try to make, I guess, time for myself, even in small ways. Mm. Like, not like that.
Like what?
You said, like.
Yeah, as in agreeance.
Okay. He means masturbating.
Yeah.
That's what he means.
He's like, that's not what I was talking about, though.
I can work way longer and have way more focus if I just rub one out real quick. Right before I get going. Cry More Art has never looked better.
What do you think the girls look the way they do?
Yep. Gotta give myself some material.
No. Anyway. No, like, just doing, like, small sketches for myself.
Yeah.
Like, I just, like, or I go on lunch break and I'll draw something that I want to draw or just random. And that's how I stay focused, I guess.
That's a good one. It helps. How do you guys find balance between the art side, brackets, drawing, creating dope art, and the business side, taxes, managing money, etc., or freelance, so you don't let one take over the other?
I think we answer this one, so Rob can answer this one again.
Wait, what was say that last part again?
So that you don't let one take over the other.
How do you balance your art, the art side of it, the creative side, and the business side?
It's very hard for me. Usually my day consists of, like, I'll wake up.
Rub one out.
No.
That's later.
Yeah, that's before you get started on the artwork.
You guys clowns. Anyway, I check my emails and reply to people. And then after that, I just get to work. And then some days, like, I'll just wake up and just get right to work. So it'll be, like, time frames where I won't even check my emails, like, for, like, 2-3 days.
Really?
Yeah.
I have my emails always open.
Yeah. It's like it's always open, but I never check it because I'm always, like, immersed.
Wow.
Yeah.
And the money stuff, how do you balance that shit out?
The money stuff is, like, it depends. It depends. Taxes is one thing, dude. Like, taxes for artists.
I hate that shit.
Yeah.
I mean, it's nice to be able to claim stuff, though.
Yeah.
Actually related to the work you do.
Yeah, I gotta start claiming stuff. Shit. Gotta start being better about claiming stuff.
Yeah.
That seems like it definitely helps.
Yep. If you poop yourself at work, do you go home sick?
No, not even do you go home sick, just what do you do?
What do you do? What would you do if you poop yourself at work? I know we work from home. Let's say you work...
Say it was your, like, hotel job.
Yeah.
Like a 9-to-5. Like, if you, like... Yeah. Like, you have to really, like, go to the bathroom and you think it's a turtle head? Or you think it's a fart and then...
No, it's, like, at work, not in the bathroom. Like, you are just sitting at your desk...
And you just shit
yourself. And you think something's funny and you laugh and just poop yourself. all the way poop yourself, not just, like, a little bit.
Not just a turtle head.
Yeah, the whole thing.
Well, I would go to the restroom.
and then what?
And then clean myself.
How are you going to do? You going to scoop it out? What are you going to do?
No, it's only in a boxer, so you just take your boxers off.
Ah, oh, dude, we're talking about, like, crazy liquid shit.
Oh my god. crazy liquid shit.
That's a tough one.
It's... Yeah, if you jello pudding in your pants, what is your next course of action? We were talking about this with the California group, and Adam said he would just quit.
That's awesome. You just sit there, you just look at your boss.
Yeah, you're just like, hey, I quit, man. I can't tell you why, but I quit. It stinks in here, and I gotta go home.
I don't want to see anyone here ever again. Yep.
That's probably the best answer. I can't think of anything, dude. It's like, I know I would leave. I would vacate the premises really fast.
As fast as you can.
It's like, even if I was, like, the only person on staff or at the desk and then just leaving.
Mm-hmm. The smell.
Yeah.
It's not good.
Yeah, I imagine it's definitely not the best.
Nah. That's awesome. Especially at your hotel job.
Yeah, hotel job, it would be really bad. Like, people checking in. What's somebody, like, checking you in?
Right?
I mean, like, I'm checking somebody in, then it just ends up happening right there.
Like, and especially if it's audible, like, they can hear it. Like,
and they're like, and their eyes get all big as you hand them their key card.
And you know, they don't want to say nothing, so they pretend it didn't happen.
It'll be awkward silence. Just looking.
Oh, God.
The sound that he made. That's just your underwear piling. Yeah.
It's really bad if you leak down your leg, too.
Oh, you know it would. You know it would. Yeah, especially if you wear just regular boxers. That's going everywhere.
Yeah. Oh, dude, if you're wearing, like, Under Armour pants, though.
It's just smashed to
it's
you.
It's just smashed into your butt.
Nah, it would just be a pool of shit. You would be marinating your own balls in your liquid poop.
That's fucked up.
To be honest, though, that would be the easiest to clean up.
Yeah, I mean, if it's stuck to you.
Yeah.
Because then you can just kind of, but you still got to get home somehow. You got to drive home with the poop on your butt.
No, dude, no. You go to the restroom, you take them off, and then you wipe yourself, and then you just go commando till you get off work or go home.
It had to seep through
your
jocks onto your pants. Unless you were smart and you already had, like, clothes.
Yeah, someone's like, hey, man. Especially depending on whatever you wear at work, it could be terrible. Like, if you wear at a job where you got to wear, like, khakis or something, and it's like, hey, man, what is that on your – did you boo-boo yourself? Like, no, I spilled coffee. You spilled coffee behind you.
Yeah, I sat on a chocolate cake.
in my pants.
Yeah, in my pants. I was trying to eat it.
Right. Someone pulled a prank on me. I went to the bathroom, and I pulled down my pants to go use the bathroom, and someone had put the toilet seat down and placed a chocolate cake.
It was a bunch of muffins.
On the toilet seat.
Yeah. And I need to go home now.
I need to quit my job.
It was like, what's that smell? It was a chocolate muffins. It was just not made.
Yeah, someone put a stink bomb inside of my cupcake.
So many excuses. You could just say, I shit myself. Right. I quit.
Yeah.
You'll never see me again.
You'll need to excuse me. I violently liquid shit myself while I was checking someone in, and I've got to go now. Forever, if at all possible. What would be worse, though?
You have to know beforehand if you think you're going to have that issue, don't you?
No. It's, in this scenario, it is completely sudden. Like, you just laughed at someone, is that something or something? Some, like, random thing that you coughed, maybe, and then just a shotgun of shit.
Or you sneeze?
Yeah. Something one that just pushes just a shotgun of poop out of you.
Ah, the force.
What is worse, though? Shitting yourself? Let's excuse shitting yourself, even. Let's say you just farted, and it was like one of those really hot ones, so you know it's going to smell really terrible. What is worse? The really hot fart where you're in a public setting and people are going to know that it happened and know that it was you because it's one of those ones that lingers. It like gets thicker the closer you are to you.
What?
Like, you can taste it.
Like it's on your skin.
Yeah, it's like a deep nasty, like a really bad one. Like you probably need to go to the bathroom soon.
Nah, I think kind of. Fart. I don't know, man.
What is worse, that or a really awkwardly visible no reason boner in a public setting? You're not wearing any drawers, just really loose sweatpants, and just holding your sweatpants up.
I would rather have a no reason burner. Because at least I know you can just look at me and be like, what?
Don't act like you're not impressed.
What? I can't do anything. What?
I don't know,
when
man.
When we default, it's just like...
It's like with the boner, you can actually like move your legs around and... Make it right. Look, or cover yourself, like lean forward. With the fart, you just no stopping.
Okay, now on the no reason boner, is it worse to have it in a group setting where you're just like around a bunch of dudes, or around a bunch of girls? Because I feel like each situation has pros and cons. Because if it's dudes. To some degree, you'd be like, oh, man, these niggas probably think that I'm gay or something.
This is cool
by
them.
Or you could be like, hey, you know how it is, dudes, no reason boner.
Because
they might understand that. Everyone's had them.
Yeah.
But with girls, I think they don't really understand the concept of a no reason boner, and they're definitely going to be a lot more
alarmed
by it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think it's funny either way, though, with the no reason boner.
Right.
Especially like these days. I'm sure as like when we were younger, we'd be way more embarrassed about it.
Mm-hmm.
But now it's just like, ah, fuck it. It's there.
Yeah. But I don't know, man. I think turtle head accidental fart that turns into a poop is the worst.
Which is the best possible way to describe that.
It is.
Turtle head into poop.
Yeah. Like, you know, you got the fart. Like, you know it's coming. Like, it's a fart. You know it's know it's gas, but it comes out like a turtle head. Like,
just pebbles. A bunch
of big, not even. Just like
nuggets.
Yeah, that's what we're talking about.
That's fucked up. No thanks. No thank you. And if you're sitting down, it's probably going to be like worse.
Yeah.
Speaking of that, Amanda just corrected me over the text message.
About?
Okay. She said, a turtle head is when the poop is coming out. So, have you ever been in that situation where you have the poop so bad, but you can't?
Yes. Yeah.
What, because of your location?
Yeah, like you can't just go. You can't go. Like you can't by any means necessary go.
You mean like constipation, or you can't because
it's about the blow. Like it's about the blow out your hole. Like you can't hold it.
Okay.
Oh yeah. That's how I failed my driving test.
He's like, I am going to actually poop.
Yeah.
If we don't stop this.
I was trying to get back to the location, and I'm like, this is bad. This is the worst possible situation. And
you don't think you could have told the guy? Like,
I told him. And he's like, a poop situation. You have to finish the test. And I'm like, I don't know. I don't think it's worth it.
It's like, hey, can I get out real quick and poop on the side of the road and then finish it?
He said, we're almost there.
How did that adventure end for you?
I failed the test. I ran to the toilet and I relieved myself.
He didn't pass.
But you weren't there yet.
No, we were like, it was like literally across the road when it was just.
And you just got out of the car and ran into the school?
Kind of. I quickly parked it, but I didn't park it properly, and that's how I failed.
Right on.
But it was awesome.
I don't know. Like I think I've told Jeff this, but I don't know if I've ever told Rob. Unless it is a fucking hella bad emergency, no. Will not poop in a public restroom.
No, yeah, I don't. Yeah. I'm the same way.
It's got to be falling out of me kind of emergency. No.
That's the only times I will actually go. This one, I swear, it was turtle.
Yeah,
no, I didn't know that.
No, yeah.
When you're driving as well, and you're like, I'm being tested. So he's paying attention to everything I'm doing.
You should have just pooped, man.
In a car?
Yeah. I'm like, you should have just fucking took one for the team and pooped. And be like, hey, I told you it was going to happen. I'm going to finish this test. You're going to sit here in the car with me with this poop smell. And you're going to give me a passing fucking grade. Because you made me shit myself.
That would have been amazing. No, I didn't. And would have stained everything.
That poop just happened, and it's on your hands.
Oh, that would be awful if it's in his hands. It wasn't. Yeah, that was a fun day.
Yeah, that doesn't sound.
Oh man.
Anyway, on that poop note, that sounds like a good place to end it.
Yeah.
So we'll keep this one a slightly shorter one.
The normal.
We'll try to keep it about this, about an hour or so.
On a weekly basis?
On a weekly basis, if we can make that happen.
I think it's doable.
Hopefully. Though I still think we need to start doing these drink and draw ones, and Rob can participate in those as well.
Mm. Wait, what was that again?
Wait, what?
We just draw something while we're doing the podcast. And we post whatever we were drawing during the podcast while we were sitting.
Oh, I was actually going to suggest.
Were we supposed to be doing a switch around thing?
Switch around thing.
We can do that next podcast.
All right, sweet.
Okay. And also for the audience, if you guys want to ask us like more thought provoking questions like this,
like the shit one?
These deep thought provoking questions, deep, like if you've almost pooped yourself.
And also art related questions.
Not just, related, anything yeah. related, whatever, we'll answer. Who gives a shit?
Yeah.
But yeah. Yeah. So we'll see you all the next one. It was good. Hope you enjoyed it. We had a good time. See you on the next one.
Cheers.
Deuces.
Peace.
Chipper chat, this is chipper chat chat. This is premier rap. That what chipper chap chat is. Podcast made from two nerdy brown boys, both 30 years old, buying all the fresh toys. One of us anime, other Marvel fanboys, both drawing hella shit, bringing fans hella joy. Both love to talk shit, that you make it more noise. If you're in a pirate game, don't fuck with these boys.
The name is Jeffrey, but I'm also named Chamba. Born in the fields and raised up in the land down under. Picked the pens and paper at the age of four, and since more than a phaser developed the passion and draw. Pictures of dinosaurs and robots with transformation, mutant turtles and many things beyond my imagination. This continued for several years, it went on, even beyond for speeding up with FooRay at Comic Con. Collabed on artwork and even on a podcast with Rob called C.L.A.S.S.A.C.T. It sucks that it didn't last, but it's all good. We're keeping busy, still drawing every day. There's little chance of this addiction to suddenly fade away. And let me say, drawing up comics is great. RandomVeus Volume 2 is next on what I'm gonna make. Okay, it seems I've covered things about this and that on this new intro to the Chipper Chat Chat.
What up, Chipper Chat? This is Chipper Chat Chat. This is premier rap. That what Chipper Chat Chat is. Podcast made from two nerdy brown boys, both 30 years old, buying all the fresh toys. One of us anime, other Marvel fanboys, both drawing hella shit, bringing fans hella joy. Both love to talk shit, that you make it more noise. If you're in a pirate game, don't fuck with these boys.
Your passion is Christ-like when I'm rocking on this mic. The way you rip it up's like Wolverine in a knife fight. Samurai in a past life, leave your head with one swipe. I rock you when I'm on it, cause my rhymes the stalactite. Spit so fully clean, you will swear I'm spitting crest. My lyrics sit so hard that you can feel it in your chest. I know that I'm the shit, and it's not to be disputed. A viewer tried to do it, but it's never executed. I battle your best, you can even pay-per-view it. Your whole crew will stop and say, would you look at what Boo did? Chamba flips in with the off-the-rope elbow. FooRay up next, flipping out red arrow. This tag team flow, rapping about our talk show. Call Funk Master Flex, Chipper Chap about the bro.
Shows and all of these movies. If it's cool, the many that we know, well, we know to many that you'll show. Cause we both want all of this to grow. They're taking over the world.
What up, Chipper Chat? This is Chipper Chap Chat. This is premier rap. That what Chipper Chap Chat is. Podcast made from two nerdy brown boys, both 30 years old, buying all the fresh toys. One of us anime, other Marvel fanboys, both drawing hella shit, bringing fans hella joy. Both love to talk shit, that you're making more noise. If you're in a pirate game, don't fuck with these boys. What up, Chipper Chat? This is Chipper Chap Chat. What up, Chipper Chat? This is Chipper Chap Chat. What up, Chipper Chat? This is Chipper Chap Chat. What up, Chipper Chat? This is Chipper Chap Chat.